skyscrapers. Ever wonder why we have them? Millions of people live and work in our city, yet we don't have much land. Skyscrapers let us go upward so we have room for a lot of people where there's not a lot of space. Like that beauty, one of the world's tallest, an office building that holds more people than a small town. If I sound proud, that's because I helped build it. I'll show you how the job was done. For that, let's go back to the beginning. That's me at my drawing board. I'm an architect, one of dozens of people who planned and designed the building. We wanted it to be a safe, comfortable place for the people who'd be working inside. We showed our plans with drawings that gave directions for constructing every single inch of the building. After months of planning, crews of construction workers finally got started.
We took steel parts weighing 5 tons each and bolted them down. Before long, the frame was rising from the ground. Large cranes lifted the heavy steel beams up to where we were working, connecting thousands of steel parts one by one. When we came to the very last beam, what a day that was. We all signed our names. Then, with well-known people like the mayor, we watched proudly as the beam was lifted into the air. It was called the topping out ceremony. After months of hard work, this was our way of celebrating that we finally finished the steel frame.
While the frame was going up, another crew attached heavy marble slabs to the outside of the building. While the outside was being finished, inside people were already building the offices.
I put in metal ventilators that carry warm and cool air through the building. I'm only one of hundreds who helped get the building ready for people to work in. You know, building a skyscraper takes so many special jobs that no one person could learn them all. So we each become experts at just one kind. Carpenters do woodwork, others do metalwork. Specialists, that's what we are. After all, thousands of people would soon be working here. We wanted their offices to be safe, comfortable.
Our design for the building included a place where people could sit outside and relax. That's the purpose of the plaza, the space around the building. The plaza is a place where people can take a break from a hard day's work. One night, almost 2 years after the construction began, moving vans arrived carrying office furniture. The first people were moving in. Moving's done at night because that's when the city and the building are not so crowded. Bit by bit, the offices began looking like offices. And a few days later, people were working there. The building was finally being used.
I like this building. It has all sorts of conveniences. High-speed elevators can get from the bottom floor to the top in just 1 minute. On the first and second floors, we have escalators. Those first two floors also have stores. We can shop without even leaving the building. Getting lunch is no problem because we have not one restaurant, but two. One's a cafeteria, and the other a cafe. We even have a bank. You know, you could almost call this building a city within a city.
That's my building, and quite a building it is. 82 stories standing over 330 meters high, with 40 elevators and almost 5,000 windows, and nearly 10,000 people who work inside. Constructing it took hundreds of people more than 2 years, but the work was all worthwhile when you see the result. A building that serves those who work inside and the city around it.